Show we got for you tonight. You wouldn't believe it, Robin. Unbelievable.
Who's
look at me.
This? What show is this?
You know, this is a stupid show.
I keep coming to do the Howard Stern show, and then you show up.
I'm supposed to look like James T. Kirk.
I don't know what happened to you, Captain.
Of the USS Enterprise.
What, did your face blow up?
What's the matter, ladies? You don't recognize the captain of the Star Trek?
No, we don't.
The Star Trek Enterprise.
Let me tell you something. These, by the way, are the female Globetrotters. I don't know if you've heard of the Harlem Globetrotters. These ladies are professional basketball players.
We are. Thanks very much.
No. Let me tell you what happened here. We have a little bit of a problem at the top of the show, and we're not one to hide our problems. As of last week, booked on this show was Lieutenant Hoare.
No.
What?
Uhura.
Lieutenant, what is it?
Uhura.
That's what I said, Lieutenant Hoare. No, we had Lieutenant Uhura booked. Nichelle Nichols. How come black people always take names and mess them up a little bit? Isn't the name Michelle with an M?
No, it's Michelle.
Michelle.
Yeah. You heard that Beatles song, Michelle My Bell?
Michelle My Bell. Is that the song?
Yeah.
What are you guys, nuts? The name is Michelle. This is America. All right, whatever. Anyway, so listen, we had her booked for the show, and what happens is she cancels on us as of an hour or two ago.
Right, yeah, just before the show.
And we wrote a great Star Trek sketch. So using my, and look, hey, by the way, this is the woman we really had booked on the show. This is 20 years she metamorphosized into this. Isn't that unbelievable? Imagine you marry this, and then... Well, hey, look, I personally don't know if she was sick or not. She claimed she was sick. I'm not going to call the woman a liar. So I thought quickly. We went out on the street,
yeah,
and we met a couple of women who we think look a little bit like Nichelle. And I was thinking one of these ladies could become...
Nichelle for the
Star Trek sketch. Because we have the big Star Trek sketch coming up. Yes. Yeah, okay. It's going to be fun. And these are the best actresses we could find in 10 minutes. Now, how did we find these ladies?
Let me
show a little piece of tape, and then you'll decide, Robin, along with me and the guys, who we're going to have play Michelle Uhura. When are you going to be Uhura?
Did you always want to be Uhura when you were growing
Absolutely.
Up?
I did.
Oh, yeah? You always dreamt about being Uhura?
Yes, I did. I watched Star Trek.
Wait till you see our sketch. It's going to be a nightmare. All right, here we go. Here's your audition. This is how we met you guys.
Hi, your name is?
Chantal St. Floor.
And you're willing to try out for the part of Lieutenant Uhura?
I am.
Do you know who she is?
No, not...
Excuse me, Chantal.
Yes?
What the hell's on your head?
It's a combo. Banana hat.
Banana hat, all right. You know who had a hat like that, Robin? Remember the late Pinky Lee?
No.
That's
I didn't know Pinky.
That's Pinky Lee, I'm telling you. But it's very attractive on you. It looks very nice. You girls are very nice looking.
Well put together.
You ladies attracted to me at all?
No.
You all look like you want it from Captain James T. Kirk. USS Enterprise.
Produce him and we'll get it.
What's that?
Produce him and we'll get
produce
it.
Produce him and he'll get it?
Really?
All right, let's hear.
Well, I think we got our girl right here.
Oh.
What do you know about her?
She was a communication specialist and her name means freedom in Swahili.
Well, I think she's high in the running. And you are?
Marie Bruno.
Hey, wait a second.
What?
She really knows Uhura.
Oh, she knows her Star Trek. You can tell.
That's unbelievable. I can't believe it. I mean, Sam, now your hat is also very unusual. But that hat, that's the most unusual. Does that hat catch a lot of rain?
Oh,
seriously,
no.
If you walk out with that hat, if you're in the rain with that hat, you could catch a lot of rain in there, couldn't you?
I don't know.
Well, you ladies have some sense of humor, I got to tell you. All right, let's go.
And why do you think that you should be Lieutenant Uhura in a Star Trek sketch?
Because I'm just a wonderful leader.
Have you ever done any acting before?
No.
I have.
You have?
Yes, in school.
What kind of acting have you done?
Oh, in school, Rutgers University. My freshman year, I just did, supporting actress. That's it.
Okay. Yeah. Have you ever kissed another woman before?
Never.
Have you ever kissed another woman?
No, and I've never been interested.
You ever kissed another woman?
Yeah, my mother.
Could you do a little sample of the character of Uhura for us?
Open the frequency, Captain. Captain Kirk, I'm getting an emergency transmission. I cannot make out what language it is in. I don't know if it's Romulan or what. What should I do?
Wait a second. I got to
answer. Very nice.
I got to answer something. Are you bald?
No.
No. All right. I just want to know. That's all. Hey, I'm not trying to be too forward. That's all. Here we go. Let's continue with the tape. That was a very good audition.
Very good reading.
She's getting a lot of points, lady. She's starting to blow you right away, if you know what I mean. All right.
How about you? You want to try out, do an on-camera try for the part of Uhura?
Okay, I am a Star Trek fan, but I don't quite remember Lieutenant O'Hara. Open a hailing frequency, Captain. Captain, I'm getting a reading from the computers here, and I'm not quite sure what it is. Can you, Captain, calling Captain.
You know, you're not a bad actress, I'm going to tell you that. You know what your hairstyle reminds me of? Remember the late Elvis Presley? He wore his hair like that.
Yeah,
that's a, Elvis had his hair like that. I saw him right in the grave, I'm telling you. All right, here we go. A very good read, by the way.
Good, good, good. How about you?
Oh, my God. Okay. Captain, I'm hearing something. I don't know what it is. Captain. Captain, it's getting louder. Oh, my God. I hear screaming.
Did you wear a bikini on the Harris?
Of course. Yes.
They don't make them my size.
We can get a bikini in any size.
They don't make them. They don't, and they don't make them to cover up what I got to hide.
Ma'am, are you staying to try out for the part of Lieutenant
O'Hara? No. I'm a grandmother. I would be ashamed of myself. I knew when I was young. I went to it for $1 million, and he's a jerk.
Oh dear.
Ma'am. Ma'am, do I have permission to use that on the Howard Stern show?
Yes.
Well, there she goes. Well, what do you know about that? Well, let me
tell you. Well, we didn't hear an audition from you.
Yeah, you didn't audition.
Well, because the camera wasn't there when I was there.
Listen, let me tell you girls something. I looked all of yous over, and I know who I'm voting for. And I don't
give
mean
me a chance, though.
All right, let me hear you do your best O'Hara. Go ahead.
Okay. Can I use the chair for
sure,
a second?
No,
let me tell you something. Unless you put a towel on your head and an earring in your nose, I don't think you're going to get the part. I'm going to be honest with you.
All right,
go ahead.
Give me a second.
Now, why do you want to be the chair? Are you lazy? Why
because
can't you do it standing up? All right, go
she
ahead.
Was in the chair at the... Okay.
All right, quickly.
All right. And Captain, I'm getting messages from Star Trek, from Starbase headquarters.
Are you out of your mind with that audition? Come on.
All right.
Let me tell you something. A bit of advice. Spend less time fiddling with your hair and more time with your acting lessons. Let's take you hours to do all that, for God's sake. It's unbelievable. You must take hours on that hair. All right, listen to me. Robin, my vote is for this woman over here.
Well, she knew O'Hara the best.
Now, let me tell you girls something. This is going to be our next segment. We're going to do a Star Trek sketch. Since this woman didn't show up, O'Hara... Put this around your neck, because you're going to be O'Hara.
That's why we'll know who you're playing.
And don't you dare take that towel off your head. That's the funniest thing I ever saw. I love it.
And it's not a towel, it's a kima.
A kima? That's a towel, honey, and I know a towel when I see one. You call it a kima, I call it a towel. I'm telling you that. I never saw anything like that. But anyway,
kima
listen.
Is towel in Swahili.
You're damn right, but this ain't Swahili over here, I'll
kima
tell you that.
Kima is head-veiling Arabic.
Now, let's see. Go widen the doors on the Enterprise. Let me tell you that
we'll have more space to get through.
Let me tell you the basic sketch. This is going to be the best sketch we've ever done, Robin.
All right.
When we come back, I will be Captain James T. Kirk. Baba Booey will be Spock.
Ah.
Jackie and Fred will be in it. Elephant Boy is in it.
Uh-huh.
And we get contacted by the lesbian planet of Lesbos. And O'Hara is captured by lesbians.
Uh-oh.
And then the action begins. This is going to be your greatest acting role ever. Are you psyched? Are you ready?
Yeah, I know how I'd act.
Are you psyched up?
Oh, yes.
You are going to be locked in a cage on a lesbian planet.
Mm-hmm. Do I get to take my brass knuckles with me?
You get to take your brass knuckles with you, all right? By the way... Send your hate mail to Ralph, the makeup man. He's the guy who made me up like this.
I'm still trying to figure out who you look like.
I don't know who I look like. I swear to God, I look like Merv Griffin from last week.
Don't laugh too hard. You might crack your
face. I might crack my... Let me bring out our spokesmodel right now, our Snapple girl. Ladies. Oh. Yes. Oh, man. Right over there. Stand right over there. What's the matter with you? Wow. Now, this is Laura Fodor.
Boater.
Anyway, look what you're holding. You're holding beautiful Snapple. Have you ever tasted this product?
Yes.
What do you think of it?
They're delicious.
Isn't it great? Isn't it a
Love
great
them.
Product?
Very good.
What's your favorite?
This.
What is that? I don't
Actually,
think you
I
ever
left.
Drank Snapple, did
yes,
you?
Yes, I have.
I want you to tell the truth. Did you drink Snapple?
Yes, I have.
And didn't you get turned on to Snapple by J.J. Smelly? All right, look, this is a great product. Let me tell you something. This is 100% fruit juice. Everybody loves it. It's passion supreme. Do you understand what Snapple means? Ladies, do you understand what Snapple means? Have you ever tasted this, ladies?
Yeah, raspberry iced tea is the best in the world.
Raspberry iced tea. You ladies know. You girls are intelligent. You know what's happening in the world. You know that if you have children, any of you have
all
children?
Natural. Yeah.
All natural, 100% all natural. That's right.
Why, we're spreading the word of Snapple.
Now, I want to do a test with the Snapple. Now, this woman with the yellow hat on. Do you mind if I pour Snapple into your hat and we see what happens?
See how much Snapple your hat
will hold? See how much Snapple your hat will hold?
I don't think it'll hold that.
You don't think it'll hold that much? All right. Well, it has no sugar, no preservatives, no artificial flavors. Get Snapple, made from the best stuff on Earth. When we come back, the Star Trek sketch. Don't go away.
We must beam down immediately to the planet Lesbos.
Ladies, ladies, Lesbos.
Captain's log, stardate 362436DD. We've been ordered by Starfleet Command to circle the planet Lesbos in the Clitorian galaxy. The planet Lesbos, inhabited by well-meaning yet annoying lesbians. Kirk, here. What?
Captain, you must come quickly. It's Lieutenant Uhuru. She's been captured by those friggin' lesbians on the planet Lesbos.
Uhura, snatched by lesbians. Scotty, I'll be with you in a minute. You know I'm dealing with this Captain Pike mess.
Captain, please hurry. It's horrible.
What? So horrible? That Uhura's been captured?
No, it's your bad toupee and that horrible potbelly. Haven't you heard about the Stairmaster, Captain?
Oh, shut up. You disgust me. I'll be right with you, Scotty. Captain Pike. I need your advice. Please, help me. Give me the words. Oh, Spock, look at Captain Pike. It's horrible.
Should I give him the Vulcan mind melt both?
Shut up, you baboon-faced moron.
Captain, Commander Pike is trying to talk.
Or is lost. Give up the sketch now.
What a mess you are, Captain Pike. Look at you. My God, what are you saying?
All is lost. Give up the sketch now.
Spock, what is he saying? What?
I think what he is trying to say is, all is lost. Give up the sketch now.
Captain, look quickly off the starboard bow.
Thank you, Mr. Scott. On screen.
Captain, I believe we are circling the lesbian planet Lesbos.
That's not the planet Lesbos. That's our executive producer's head.
He's behaving strangely.
My heavens. Look now. What's that horrible vision?
I've only heard about it. It's the disgusting moons of Stern.
My God. That's disgusting. Bones. What do you make of those strange moons? Bones? Mr. Bones. Bones, where are you?
Over here, Jim.
My God. Bones, you look terrible.
I know. Channel 9 pays real bad.
Fascinating, Captain. Fascinating.
What's so fascinating, you annoying idiot?
I don't know. Everything is fascinating to me.
Captain, on screen.
Yeah. That's the planet Lesbos. It is such a beautiful planet. The most feminine planet in the galaxy. Open a hailing frequency. Mr. Spock?
Excuse me, Boff.
Don't call me Boff. Call me Captain.
Okay, Captain Boff. Highly logical.
A little self-discipline, will you?
Captain, we're receiving a signal from the planet Lesbos.
My God, Jackie, you're acting. You're an idiot.
All right.
Put it up on the screen immediately.
For goodness sakes, Captain.
My God.
It's the leader of the Lesbos colony.
Yeah.
I know her well, Captain. Her name is Labiana.
Labiana. I will establish diplomatic contact.
Aye.
Labiana.
Excuse me, Labiana. Labiana. Excuse me. Excuse me. Excuse me.
Fascinating. Most illogical.
Ladies, ladies, Lesbo. Labiana, we must beam down immediately to the planet Lesbos. Gentlemen.
Should I go to red alert?
Yes, Spock. Set your breath to stun. Scotty, Bones, Spock, prepare to beam down. Gentlemen, I look a mess for the lesbians, don't I? What the hell happened to my face? What happened to me? Look at my hair. It can't even stay on. Captain Pike, we'll be right back for you from the planet Lesbos, okay?
Beam me back a lesbian when you come back.
What did you say?
Beam me back a lesbian when you come back.
Oh. What did he say, Spock?
He said, bring me back a lesbian when you come back.
Where did they go? Where did they go?
Oh, where is this?
Captain.
Beam down my toupee, you freaks. How do I look for the lesbian?
Captain, please help me. These women are holding me prisoner.
Yes, Uhura. You've obviously got a big problem.
Most illogical. Fascinating.
My God, look at all these rocks on the planet.
Captain, you're bald.
My God, you didn't know Uhura? I mean, for God's sakes, you've been on this show since 1966 and you didn't know I was bald? What, have you been in a coma? What? You, wait a second, excuse me. These are the rocks in my head for signing with Channel 9. That's the rocks, that's what that is. Yes, lesbians, what is it?
Captain, we are the ladies of Lesbos. Why have you come to the galaxy of Clitoria? It's so hard to find.
Yes, it was easy for us. We turned left at Uranus. Say, what are these pictures over here?
These are women that we worship. Martina, the queen of tennis.
Yes.
And Sandra because of her powerful lips.
So on your planet, you only love women?
Yes.
Why do you all hate men?
Because this was the last man on our planet. We ripped out his spine and beat him to death with it.
Never mind all that fish face. What are you going to do with Lieutenant Uhura?
Fascinating.
What's that, the lesbians?
No, Scotty's acting.
Captain, we're holding your Lieutenant Uhura hostage. Unless you give us 5,000 cucumbers and your toupee.
I understand the cucumbers, but why? Why the toupee?
Because there are no absorbent feminine hygiene products on our planet. And we need something very absorbent, like your toupee.
You are some little actress. You are much better than the average stripper, aren't you? For God's sakes, I think your breast implants are leaking into your brain. I'll tell you what, lesbians. I will get you the cucumbers, but the toupee is non-negotiable.
This is highly illogical.
I must save Uhura. My ship, my crew, my very command depends on it.
Let me out. I think I have the solution.
Yes, Uhura, what is it? Let her out, please.
Yo, why are you touching me?
You are some actress. She's better than us, and she doesn't do anything.
Captain, look. Why don't I stay on this planet? I could live here, stay with these women, maybe teach them a few things.
Spend eternity without a man. It's unthinkable. The ultimate sacrifice. And what about poor Bones? I know how the two of you feel about each other.
I'll miss him.
Damn it, Jim. I love her. I'm a doctor, and I'll miss giving her a pap smear.
Yeah.
Captain, my decision is final. And besides, how much longer do you think I can sign autographs at those Star Trek conventions?
Well, Uhura, I can see you've made up your mind. But please, as a remembrance, let us take your do-rag with us into outer space so we can remember you. What kind of impression am I doing?
Live long and prosper.
I'm glad we can be friends now.
Yes, I am too, Labiana.
We trust you, Captain. You're not a woman, but you're very close.
Yes, I am. Mr. Sulu, four to beam up.
Captain's log, supplemental. As much as mankind has advanced in the last 1,000 years, nothing gives me a Woody like two babes making out. Mr. Sulu, warp speed ahead.
Black folk with white features. The show that asked the question, is you black or is you white? And now, the man with less than prominent African features, Howard Washington Stein.
I dig that music that we have at the top of the show, Robin. You know, hello, everybody. Look, my hat on straight.
Yes, it is.
You know what this here X is for?
No, what is that for?
That stands for extra crispy.
Oh.
See, man, when we think of a black man or woman, you think of, like, Florida, or maybe you think of Mammy. But many of us do not wear our race on our sleeve. You see, man, I am a black man, and I am born to two black parents, yet I can pass for a white man.
Are you upset that you can pass for white?
Excuse me, Robin?
Are you upset that you can pass for white?
Well, of course I'm upset, woman. I am not accepted by blacks because I'm too light-skinned.
Uh-huh.
And whites think that I'm too black, see?
So where do you fit in?
Well, it's hard to say. You know, why do I sound like Soupy Sales?
I don't know what you're doing.
See, there are lots of people who have the same problem as me. For example, yeah. Vanessa Williams. She looks white, but she is black, in fact.
Mm-hmm.
Then you got Mayor Dinkins.
Uh-huh. Looks, he's got the same problem.
He got the same problem. He looked white, but he is black.
Uh-huh.
You can take Kim Basinger.
Now, I didn't know she was black.
Well, she looks white, but she is black. Although the lips are a giveaway. Now, George Takei, Sulu of the Star Trek.
Yeah?
Sulu looks white, but he is black.
No way.
And now for the real shock. I am going to reveal something right now. Well, Robin, you should reveal this. Tell the shock.
Well, for the real shock, Howard, let me tell everyone that you and I are brother and sisters. I'm your biological sister.
That's right, Robin. You see, we have the same parents, but oddly enough, you have full African features, as well as a full set of chocolate markers.
Oh, jeez. That's right, Howard.
That's right. Now, let me just say, the guest tonight is a woman who is no stranger to this problem. She is black, but she looks white. Please welcome Sabrina LaBarre. Now, Sabrina, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Well, it's nice to meet you, too.
Sabrina, you look white, but you are, in fact, black. Is that true?
I don't think so.
Well,
don't think you're black?
I think I'm black, but I don't think I look white.
Oh, you've never been mistaken.
No, never.
Now, have you ever tried to make yourself look more black like myself?
No, I haven't.
Because you even sound white.
Really?
Yeah, you really do. Do you ever try to put on a southern accent?
No, I don't.
Robin, do you think Sabrina looks black or white?
Well, she's, you know, very light, but I think she looks black.
You think
she looks black?
Yeah.
I think she looks white. Now, I'd like to ask you about your work on The Cosby Show.
Right.
You work with, you want to borrow my hat to look more black?
No, that's okay.
Would you like to wear my
hat? So people don't get confused.
How come you don't wear an X hat?
See, you never wear the top of your head.
Really divine. My hair, you know.
You're asking about The Cosby Show?
Now, The Cosby Show, right. You work with Bill Cosby.
Yes.
And you work with Felatio Rashad.
Right.
And
that's Felicia.
Felatio Rashad.
No, it's Felicia.
No, that is pronounced F-Y-L-L-I-C-I-A, Felicia. You work with Bill Cosby, Felatio Rashad, and all the Cosby kids, and they are so black. The Malcolm and John Warner is
what?
So black. The boy on The Cosby Show is so black.
Malcolm Jamal?
All of the children on The Cosby Show could pass for Nigerian exchange students.
Oh, no.
And yet you could be an ivory girl.
No.
You know what I'm saying? Did they ever explain that on the show?
No, because black people come in a whole range of colors.
But how is it that Bill Cosby is so chocolatey brown and Felicia Rashad is so brown and you are the only light-skinned child on The Cosby Show?
No, that's not. How about Lisa Bonet?
Lisa Bonet is looking black, though. You look white. See, to me, she look white. Let me ask you this. Do you date white men or black men?
Uh-oh.
I mean, you're so white, you're Johnny Winter's sister.
Oh, jeez.
No, really, do you date the black man or the white man?
When I used to date, I dated all of them.
All colors of the Rainbow Coalition?
Yes.
But she said used to date. Are you married?
Yes, I'm married.
You're married to a white man?
Yes, I am.
See, that's what I thought. Now, as a child, did you sandpaper yourself or anything? Now, that's what, you know, a lot of brothers and sisters do. You see what I'm saying?
I never heard of that. I was born this way.
You born that color?
Yeah, this color.
Let me ask this, Robin, and maybe if I'm out of line, you tell me.
All right.
Do black men ever call you honky? Have anyone ever said, hey, honky?
No, they've never made that mistake.
See, Robin, that's
what happened to you.
Do people call you names?
Yeah, because my sister here, she has no problem. We have the same parents, and she is so chocolatey black, and we, of course, with chocolatey...
Enough already.
So
enough.
When you're with her, you pass.
I gotta admit, I'm turned on by my own sister. They're wild. Robin, I'll tell you something. This is great. You know, it's funny. Some people call me white. Some people call me black. Some people call me stupid. You understand that?
I think most people.
But you got a white husband.
Right.
And and you have brothers and sisters?
Yes.
And they're as light-skinned as you?
Yes.
But you had a black father and a black mother?
Yes.
Wow, that is amazing.
Isn't that amazing?
Isn't that amazing?
Oh, well, I want to learn more. Over to you, Robin.
Yes? Well, we'll come back with... more on this topic.
Yes. And we will meet the strong black woman who birthed me for the first time, and Sabrina will meet her as well.
Yes, coming up, our mother and father.
We'll be right back.
We're back with the show that axes the question, are you black or are you white? And here's your host, Howard Washington Stein.
Question this evening is, are you black or are you white? I am black, but I look white. My guest, Sabrina LaBeouf, is black.
LaBeouf.
LaBeouf or LaBeouf?
She's correct.
LaBeouf. Well, I would like to LaBeouf you, I'll tell you that, honey. Both Sabrina and myself look white, Robin, and yet you, my biological sister, look black.
Yes. Howard, share with the audience how you prove that you are black.
Well, first of all, I don't need to really prove it to anybody if I am black or white. What about you, Sabrina? Do you always ask, people asking you to prove that you was black or white? Do you have to prove to people you're black?
No, that's never happened to me. I can't say in my experience.
See, look at even on the show. Look at the show, Robin. You see, this is the Cosby
this
Show.
The whole family.
They are the blackest parents, and yet Sabrina is white.
Well, she looks darker in this picture.
No, you look. I don't know. I don't know what's going on.
I look darker than Lisa.
Well, I don't know. That picture's a lie. Now, let me ask you to identify if the following celebrities are black or white, Sabrina. This is Jane Kennedy. To you, is she black or is she white?
I'd say she's black.
You would say that she is black?
Yeah, because the kinds of films she's done, I'd say she's black.
And yet, she looks white. Now, up on your screen is Colin Powell. Is he black or white? Sabrina Colin Powell.
I'll pass on that one. We'll ask Robin about that one.
Now, here is a real shocker for our audience at home. Robin, Nick Nolte is black.
Now, how do you know this?
I know it because I know his parents are black. And a little known fact, our own producer of this show, Dan Foreman, is black.
No, I will not accept that.
Oh, yes. The white race will not take him. Sabrina, at this point in the show, I would like to introduce to you my parents and Robin's parents.
Wonderful.
They are our parents.
Here are our folks, Mr. and Mrs. Washington Stern.
Yes. Hello, mother and father. Take a seat.
Awesome.
Nice to meet you.
Very nice to see you, mom and dad.
Hi, mom and dad.
All right. Well, now watch me act black. Hey, dad, slap me 5. See? Mom, you got something to say to me?
Not even though you look white. We still love you.
Yes. Sabrina, do you have dark parents or do you have white parents, light-skinned parents? My parents are very dark.
My parents are pretty much my color.
Except
my dad has green eyes.
Wow,
and I have brown eyes.
Yeah. I can't believe it. I tell you, my family reunions are frightening.
I can imagine.
When the four of us get together, it's a very, very sad occasion, I'll tell you that. Now, Dad, would you like to say something to Sabrina, our guest from The Cosby Show?
Sure. Where did you get such a beautiful thing like this? Baby, I love you.
Oh, no, Dad. Oh.
Now.
What about your wife?
Now, Dad, you calm down. Really, for goodness sake. Now, I believe that Sabrina wanted to talk about some animals. Now, you is here.
You've got lots of them here.
Now, you got a lot of animals. Dad, would you take your...
Just calm down, Dad.
Dad, what you doing, man? Goodness sake.
Lovely woman here.
Let me ask you something now. You involved with a...
Would you like to go on my jet with me now?
Jet? We'll go away.
You got no jet.
Money.
You
need some money? You really don't need no money?
I don't need any money, actually.
Why not? You want to, let's get on a jet and go to Europe. Now.
Mom.
Right now.
What do you think?
Dad, we had enough of you, all right?
No.
We wrote you one line in this here. Get your hand. Get away from her. That's
just
all
just
I mean.
Move back over near your wife.
Hey, you know what, Dad? Dad, I think your hat is too tight. Take your arm away from Sabrina.
Put your arm around Mom and
be quiet. I'm going to physically move you out of here. Now, Robin, is that our show?
Well, she was going to say something about Peter, wasn't she?
Yeah, I'm going to get one plug in here.
All right, now let's talk about the animal rights.
And I brought it.
Yes.
A shopping guide for caring consumers.
Yes.
Put out by People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals.
Now, you love what, cats or dogs or something like that?
Yes, all of them. And
now,
even black and white people both can get into this, okay?
Now, let me ask you about Peter.
Right.
Is he black or is he white, this Peter character?
He's mixed.
He is of mixed origin?
Yes.
Now, let me ask you something. I would like to introduce you to someone else. This is my half-brother.
You're going to bring out our half-brother?
Yes. Here is Kessler Raymond.
You know, this is your full brother.
Well, I call him my half-brother because there's so little of him. Come on, take a seat. Now, Mommy, what happened to Kessler?
When the doctor slapped him, his legs fell off.
Now, wait a second. Be serious. The doctor slapped him and his legs fell off. Give me the serious thing. What happened to little Kessler here?
Well, your silly father used a half a condom.
No. The line is... He put his condom on halfway. You know what I mean?
Okay, well.
But I always love little Kessler because we used him as third base. Isn't that right, Kessler?
Yes, sir.
Kessler, isn't it strange? Here I am, your brother, but I'm white looking, and you are so black. Come here and hug your brother on camera.
Howard, thanks for another interesting show.
Let me say something. What Sabrina is into, I would like to say I love The Cosby Show. I believe this is wholesome entertainment. I believe it is very positive. I believe that this is a good show, and it helped the black man because it gave a positive image of family life.
Very good.
I really do.
Speaking as a black man.
And I have as a black man. And I also would like to say that what you're doing with the animals is good. Because the animals are good. Animals don't see black or white. Right. They just care about people.
Right.
And we should worry about that.
Beautiful thing.
Well, of course it's beautiful. I'm trying to get in her pants. I'm going to take her backstage.
What a beautiful thing to say.
I'm going to nail her to the wall, honey.
Is that what is in her future?
You got to be a little turned on by a powerful man like myself.
You know, you're sounding just like your father.
Well, yeah. Yes, I am, sister. Let me tell you something. Well, any plans for the future after the show of The Cosby Show?
Yes, I do a lot of theater, so I'll be going down to Washington, D.C., a city filled with mostly black people, and doing
Well, you got to be careful, I'll tell you that. You got to be real careful around them. I know I'm one of them. Well, I'll tell you, not only do you have white features, but I understand from your bio that you have a white dog. Is that true? Do you have a white dog?
Oh, he died in April.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Why did you bring that up?
He's
having a good time.
Well, I want to make it like the Oprah Show where they cry. You understand what I mean? I have also learned that you were raised by your grandparents. That's a very black thing to do. That's cool. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, my grandmother was a very important influence in my life. Yeah.
See, that's good. I like that. Well, I want to thank Sabrina for coming. She's so... She's so uppity.
Oh, stop.
No, she's so great. You know what I mean. You're the best one on The Cosby Show.
Oh,
you know what I mean?
You. Thank you.
And I'm really sorry about bringing up your dog, but you got to update your bio. You know, you got to be paying that
You got to be paying that PR firm
at least $2,500 a month. I mean, they could update the bio.
Right.
You know what
then
I'm saying?
I wouldn't have to be in embarrassing situations.
Sabrina,
like this,
thank you
yeah.
for coming on our
well,
show.
Thank you for having me.
Good Robert, luck. I guess that wrap it up.
That's the show.
Unless you got some more questions.
No, that's it.
Personally, I want to get out of here. You know what I'm saying?
Thanks, Sabrina.
I'll tell you, my penis looks like my hair.
You wish.
Gentlemen, it's time once again for the Couldn't Get Into College Bowl, and here's your host, Marcus Absent.
Well, thank you for joining us at the Couldn't Get Into College Bowl. Robin?
Right, Howard. Our first contestant is a finalist for Pit House Pet of the Year. She's a frequent guest on the Howard Stern Show and an occasional sex partner of Donald Trump. Please say hello to Sandy Von Korn.
Yes.
Contestant number two enjoys playing volleyball in gym class and dance lessons with her best friend, Nicole. Please say hello to seventh grader Jessica Lippo.
Hey, Robin. Your hair is stupider than mine, I think.
I don't think so. And finally, Howard, our third and last contestant, high school voted him person most likely to drive his car into a crowded shopping mall and mow down scores of innocent people. Ladies and gentlemen, give a warm welcome to a proud representative of Postal Workers of America, Kenneth Keith Kallenbach.
Hi, how you doing? Hi, glad to be here. Hi, how you doing?
All right, very good. A lot of personality coming through from Kenneth tonight. Robin, the reason for the I couldn't get into college bowl
yes.
here is because Sandy Korn, our penthouse pet, was a spokesmodel on our show. And I asked her a couple of questions, and let's face it, Sandy, you weren't able to answer them.
No, I wasn't, but that's because it was politics. If you ask me something about my business, I know everything.
Well, what is your business?
Modeling.
Modeling.
Yeah.
Well, there will be some modeling questions.
Okay.
We are going to find out tonight just how much you know. Are you smarter than a seventh grader? Are you smarter than a postal worker like Kenneth Keith Kallenbach? That's what we're here to find out tonight. Now, here's some tape of Sandy on our show trying to answer some questions.
Are you ready for your pop quiz?
Yes.
All right. What political party is President Bush a member of?
Oh, I don't know.
You don't know that?
Sandy, come on.
Every time we have Sandy on. Now, Sandy, you were in Penthouse Magazine, right?
Yes.
And it says you're intelligent. Right.
You always say you're intelligent, but
well,
every time...
I know he's either Republican or the other one, but I don't know which one.
What is it? Now, what is the name of the other one? Is it Republicans and what?
A Democrat.
Right. And which one is President Bush?
It'd be a guess.
Go ahead.
I would say Democrat.
All right. Close enough.
All right. Now, to our seventh grader, you are no smarter than the average seventh grader, are you? Are you considered the smartest kid in your class?
No.
You are not?
No.
By any means. And Kenneth, you are certainly not the smartest kid in your class, are you?
I am too.
All right, put that aside. All right. Now, this is how it works. I'm going to ask you a question, Sandy.
Why?
Sandy, if you can't answer the question, then we'll pass it on to the seventh grader or Kenneth.
Okay.
Here we go. Sandy, your first question.
Okay.
No help from our audience. How many days are in a year?
365.
That is correct. That is one correct answer. Sandy, name an even number.
4.
That is correct. What is a clarinet?
Oh, I couldn't play one. It's those things in high school. Well, I was in high school. It's those black thing instrument with a reed on it.
That is correct. It
very
is
good.
All right, now we get into the tough questions. We've been fooling around up until now.
Okay.
What does ESP stand for? Now, let's be quiet. ESP.
I know what it is.
Well, you got to know what it stands for. I think we've hit pay dirt to the audience at home. Well, all right, Sandy, we're going to ask you to now be quiet because you obviously do not know the answer. Will you admit that ESP is not in your vocabulary?
Okay.
All right. Kenneth Keith Kallenbach, do you know what ESP stands for?
Yes, I do.
All right, go ahead.
Extrasensory perception.
Well, that's very good. What is that?
I know what it is. I just didn't know what it stood for.
All right. Well, the questions only get tougher from here. Robin, when we come back from the break,
yes,
we will come back and really get into the tough questioning because
Thank
Sandy's
you.
Done all too well.
To the Couldn't Get Into the College Bowl. Once again, here's your host, Marcus Absent.
That's right, here we are at the I Couldn't Get Into College Bowl. Well, now it's time to play our game. Yes, it's Sandy Von Korn. Sandy, who knows if you'll be able to answer these questions? You've done well in the first round. Okay, here we are. You ready?
Yes.
What country did the United States declare its independence from? No help from our audience. And no help from you over there, Robin. Are you stumped?
No. No,
you
I
only
just
have
need
a certain amount of time.
Well, I know. I get a
Well,
minute.
I'll give you a hint. It is not Kansas.
That's a state. That's not a country.
That's right. That is right. All right. What
That's
country?
No points for that.
Let's move on to our next contestant. Now, this is the kid. She is a seventh grader. What kid? What country did the United States declare its independence from, kid?
England?
That is correct.
Very good.
I was going to say that. I swear to God. I was going to say
you
that.
You ran out of time.
I was going to say that, but I've learned that it's better to not say and then be wrong.
Well, at least you've learned something right here. What was that, Robin?
I don't know. What were you saying?
No, I said it's better to say you don't know and not guess than to say something that's totally off the wall.
Well.
Ha. We all learned something today.
Where's the Twilight Zone music? I think I'm there. All right, are we ready?
Yes.
Next question.
Here we go. Are you ready, Sandy?
Yes.
I see you fidgeting over there, and I think I see a crypt sheet. What is Bush's wife's name?
Barbara.
What substance do diamonds come from?
Diamonds come from, like, rock.
From Trump.
That's true.
All right, you're having some trouble. Let's go to Kenneth Keith Kallenbach now. See if he can outwit you, our postal worker. Do you know what substance diamonds come from?
Yes. They're a substance by itself.
What? Now we need the toilet.
All right, he never disappoints. Let's go to the kid. Seventh grader.
Coal.
Coal, that is
Thank great. You.
Yeah.
Woo.
Yeah. All right, let's go to some pop trivia now, Sandy.
Okay.
What does E.T. stand for?
Extraterrestrial.
Extraterrestrial, that is correct. Who was the first president of the United States?
George Washington.
That is correct. Who built the pyramids?
God, and I know a lot about the pyramids.
Well, let me say something about
that. Wait, who are those guys?
Don't say something stupid that you might regret.
I know.
Take some time to think. Who built the pyramids? Well, let's go to the kid, the seventh grader. Let's find out. Who built the pyramids?
The Egyptians.
Egyptians.
I knew
it. Now, you say that, but you did not give the answer.
Well, she didn't want to appear stupid.
I was going to say Aztecs, but I know that's Indian.
You know,
no,
Sandy, you look
Aztecs
like...
Aztecs are Indian.
I think they're Roman.
Aren't they?
Well, while you two argue, I'm going to bring out some help for Sandy. Maybe you need some help. We have a kid here, I think it's 11 years old, is that correct?
Yes.
You want to come out and help, Sandy? Go ahead. There he is. Look at that.
Hey.
Yeah.
Hi. How are you?
Now, what grade are you in?
Sixth.
You are in sixth grade. Sandy, can you count to six?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Come on, Howard.
Well,
Sandy, is it that you don't want any help?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
All right, maybe you should keep quiet during this, kid, because maybe Sandy wants to prove she can do this on her own.
Yeah, if I, let me
because
check.
The questions get tougher
only
from
here. Only if she really needs help will
I really
ask
have
you.
To prove that I'm smart, because it's been rough.
Who was the host of The Twilight Zone? You have no idea? Because you know we are in The Twilight Zone. Was it Rod Stewart?
No.
Do you know who the host of The Twilight Zone is, kid?
No.
Do you, Kenneth Keith Kallenbach?
Yes.
Well, go ahead.
It's Pete Rose.
Pete Rose?
We're all very confused, and we want to thank you for joining us on the Couldn't Get Into College Bowl. Sandy, you did very well. Sandy, good luck to you with your penthouse and modeling and acting career. I want to thank the kid and, of course, Kenneth Keith Kallenbach. Well, until next time, good night.
Catering by Food Thoughts, Palisades Park, New Jersey. Furniture provided by Siemens Furniture, Paramus, New Jersey. Some of the female talent provided courtesy of Striptease to Go in New York City.